Today we'll be opening up the Bambu Labs AMS for the Bambu Labs X1 printer series. Install kit, which has the little buffer and cables. Looks like instructions. So this accessory is roughly, I think it was like $360, maybe, you know, a little under $400 delivered. Interesting. Up there. So a little twist lock to put that spool together. Nice. Warranty leaflet. Disclaimer, safety guidelines. Don't hurt yourself, it's not our fault, basically. And quick start. All right, so. Go over the All right, so on the back here we have the 6-pin interface and the filament outlet. Then it looks like here we have the desiccant. Desiccant goes in here underneath this. And the filament inlets, where we feed in here for the four different filaments we can put in. Then, so reusable spools. We have here the filament buffer, the 4-pin and 6-pin cables. Looks like we have some screws. Some spare filament cutters. And the PTFE tube. Okay, well, it looks like now it's time to just install it on the printer. Okay, so we have the printer here. I have my spool set up. I used a little side carriage instead of running the spool holder on the back. So go over here, I'll unload. It just goes through the automated process, heats up real quick. I mean, real fast. All right, so I just confirmed that that's done, and we'll shut her down. This right on top. Looks like it's right at home. So instructions show basically how we configure it. So it looks like this module will go in here, like that. The kit came with these screws, so we'll take these screws and get the Allen wrenches. Two millimeter Allen wrench. So take that, slide this guy here. We have a 4-pin cable and our 6-pin. So the 6-pin. Looks like they used the plug on the left. Not sure if it matters, but sure. Go to the plug on the left. Plug that in. Then we'll come right in here. Just plug it in. Look at that. This is super easy. And this little 4-pin, one goes here. The other one goes in underneath.
has a spot here. You can clip the cable in to keep it up out of the way of the shoe. It's very handy. It's like as if they thought about what they were doing. So now, we have this hose here. Alright. So then just like that. This plugs right into here. I'm just trying to make sure that I got it gripped nice. Alright. Actually even have a picture right here of what it should look like. Nice. And that's all that is. All right. It looks like that's done. And make sure we're not making a mess and leaving tools lying around. Okay. So now, looks like next step, let's take this last piece of plastic right off the front here. That opens up here, and the picture shows these just sort of shipping materials, and the cover just kind of pops right off. And in here we have our desiccant. All right. I think while I unwrap this, let's let the printer boot back up. A new firmware update has been detected. Would you like to go to the update page? Well, yes, of course. Always. The X1 and the AMS firmware needs to be updated. So we'll update both of them. I'm sure you want to update this. Take about 10 minutes. Do not turn off power while printing. Printer is updating. Yes, let's do it. All right. While that's updating, I can go. I have my filament that I was planning on using. Got some Hatchbox PLA. This one is a purple or a blue. It's called True Blue. And then this one right here called True White. Nicely right in there. And the True Blue. Look at that. Before I can even finish getting it in there, firmware has been updated. prefer to use snips, but scissors should be able to do it just fine. Turn. Let's see what we have here. AMS. If it's empty, choose an AMS slot. Then press load or unload to automatically load or unload the filament. So. There it is. That's cool. That was an event. Manufacturer. Well, some of the ones that are here. So generic material is PLA. Color white. All right. So we'll confirm. All right. So this blue right here. True blue. Let's see how this. So I have in here. If I. There it is. Whoop. It's got it. For the sake of what we do here, so all right. So we got the manufacturer, generic material. PLA, color, kind of a dark blue color, and confirm. There we go. I have my white PLA and my blue PLA. And it looks like from here, simply just close the lid. Slide locks here, so it holds it nice and closed, and yeah, I guess it's time to try and print something. Let's see how that goes. Spirit Mask. Ah. For those Avitar enthusiasts. That is really on there. It's not allowing the plate to flex off. Looks like I got some cleaning to do.